USS Freedom, LCS-1. USS Freedom, LCS-1, is the lead ship of the Freedom class of littoral combat ships, LCS. She is the third vessel of the United States Navy to be so named for the concept of freedom. She is the design competitor produced by the Lockheed Martin Consortium, in competition with the General Dynamics, designed USS Independence. She was officially accepted by the Supervisor of Shipbuilding Gulf Coast on behalf of the U.S. Navy from the Lockheed Martin / Marinette Marine / Gibbs & Cox team in Marinette, Wisconsin on 18 September 2008. She is designed for a variety of missions in shallow waters, minesweeping and humanitarian relief, capable against submarines and small ships, but not designed to take on large warships. The ship is a semi-planing monohull design capable of over 40 knots, 74 km/h, 46 mph, .9. Commissioned in Milwaukee, Wisconsin on November 8, 2008, USS Freedom is homeported in San Diego 1 and assigned to Littoral Combat Ship Squadron 110. USS Freedom is the first of two dramatically different LCS designs being produced. The other, USS Independence, LCS-2, is a trimaran built by a team led by General Dynamics Bath Iron Works and Austal USA in Mobile, Alabama. USS Freedom is designed to be a fast, maneuverable and network surface competent for missions such as anti-mine warfare, anti-submarine warfare, surface warfare, and humanitarian relief 11. The ship is a semi-planing steel monohull with an aluminum superstructure. The friction stir welded aluminum deckhouse is very flat, which, combined with an angular design, makes it difficult for radar systems to detect 12. The ship is 377 feet, 115 m, in length, displaces 3,500 metric tons, 3,900 short tons, fully loaded too, and can exceed 40 knots, 46 mph, 74 km/h, .9. The design incorporates a large reconfigurable C-frame to allow rapidly interchangeable mission modules, a flight deck with integrated helicopter launch, recovery and handling system, and the capability to launch and recover boats, manned and unmanned, from both the stern and side. The flight deck is 1.5 times the size of that of a standard surface ship, and uses a trigon traversing system to move helicopters in and out of the hangar. The ship has two ways to launch and recover various mission packages, a stern ramp and a starboard side door near the waterline. The mission module bay has a three-axis crane for positioning modules for cargo 13. The foredeck has a modular weapons zone which can be used for a 57mm gun turret or missile launcher. A rolling airframe missile launcher is mounted above the hangar for short-range defense against aircraft and cruise missiles, and .50 caliber, 12.7mm, gun mounts are provided topside. The core crew will be 40 sailors, usually joined by a mission package crew and an aviation detachment, for a total crew of about 75. Automation allows a reduced crew, which greatly reduces operating costs, but workload can still be grueling. 14. 4750 kilowatts, 1010 HP, Fincantieri Isotta Fraschini diesel generators provide 3 megawatts, 4000 HP, of electrical power to power the ship systems. 15. Concept of operations. The operational concept includes deployment of a 2 or 3 ship squadron to operate in the littorals to counter anti-access forces and to support the operations of the U.S. Navy and other friendly surface ships. The operational concept is in direct support of the U.S. Navy's maritime strategy, a cooperative strategy for 21st century sea power. Principal capabilities include shallow water anti-submarine warfare, mine countermeasures, and defense against attacking small boats. LCS ships are to be networked to share tactical information with other units. Freedom will be initially based in San Diego with two crews which will alternate four-month tours of sea duty. The Congressional Budget Office estimates that fuel will account for only 8% to 18% of the total life cycle costs for Freedom 19. Senator Jeff Sessions has called the report into question and has suggested that Independence, built in his state, would be more fuel efficient and that less frequent refuelings would affect military operations beyond the cost of fuel. 20. Construction. The construction contract was awarded to Lockheed Martin's LCS team, Lockheed Martin, Gibbs & Cox, Marinette Marine, Ballinger Shipyards, in May 2004. Her keel was laid down on June 2, 2005, by Marinette Marine in Marinette, Wisconsin. 21. The ship was sponsored by Birgit Smith, the widow of United States Army Sergeant First Class Paul Ray Smith, who was posthumously awarded the Medal of Honor in Operation Iraqi Freedom. Mrs. Smith's initials are welded on the ship's keel. The couple's St. Christopher medal and wedding bands are embedded in the ship's mast. USS Freedom was christened on September 23, 2006, delivered to the Navy on September 18, 2008, and commissioned in Milwaukee on November 8. Cost overruns during Freedom's construction combined with projected future overruns led the government to issue a stop work in January 2007. On April 25, 2008, the New York Times ran a highly critical article, arguing that both Freedom and competitor Independence demonstrated a failure of the Navy's littoral combat ship program. Prior to delivery, the U.S. Navy's Board of Inspection and Survey, INSERV, conducted acceptance trials aboard LC-1, 17, 21 August. INSERV found the ship to be capable, well-built, and inspection-ready and recommended that the Chief of Naval Operations authorize delivery of the ship. Because the trials were conducted in Lake Michigan, some ship systems, including aviation and combat systems, could not be demonstrated. Systems not demonstrated during recent trials will be presented to INSERV in early 2009 trials in Norfolk and in the open ocean. The inspection discovered 2,600 total discrepancies, of which 21 were considered high-priority deficiencies. As part of LCS-1 acceptance trials, the Navy's Board of Inspection and Survey, INSERV, identified 21 critical starred deficiencies and recommended the Chief of Naval Operations authorize delivery of LCS-1 after correction or waiver of these deficiencies. According to Navy officials, only 9 of these deficiencies were corrected prior to delivery. Navy officials report that transiting the ship away from Marinette, Wisconsin, prior to the winter freeze was a higher priority than timely correction of starred deficiencies. The Navy intends to correct remaining deficiencies during planned post-delivery maintenance availabilities. 27. One of the issues with the ship is that it is 6% overweight. This seems to have been caused by design changes during construction. The Navy says that the ship will require special operating procedures until this is corrected. The workaround selected will be to install external tanks for additional buoyancy. The Navy stated that LCS-1 now meets the damage stability requirement with the addition of the external tanks and that the design of USS Fort Worth, LCS-3, including additional stability improvements. Other issues include difficulty with the slow speed operations required for deep sea refueling, no ability to unwrap other supplies aboard other than by helicopter, and problems with side door launches of remotely operated vehicles. On June 12, 2009, the Navy confirmed that CNO Rafid had ordered a study of an early deployment of Freedom, before the expected date of 2012. Anonymous sources inside Lockheed Martin reported that Rafid wanted to use the first LCS to patrol for pirates off the coast of Somalia. On October